Good morning, everybody. Today's topic is embryology of this GIT tract. So here you can see the general outline of this GIT organ, development of this foregut, respiratory system, lung, tongue, esophagus, stomach, first part of duodenum, gallbladder, liver, and pancreas. Midgut derivative, second part of this duodenum, jejunum, ileum, cecum, and appendix. So, ascending colon and 2/3 of this transverse colon. So, these one are the derivative of this midgut. Now, derivative of this hindgut. Today we discuss about the derivative of this hindgut. Last 1/3 of this transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum, upper part of this anal canal. This one are the derivative of this midgut. Now you already see this pre-arterial segment. This one are the proximal segment. This one are the post-arterial or the distal segment. This bird name is given the sickle bird. Here there is a vitelo-intestinal duct and centrally it is supplied by this superior mesenteric artery. So you already know about the source of the development of this adult derivative of this midgut, jejunum, ileum, cecum and appendix, ascending colon, proximal 2/3 of this transverse colon. They all are the adult derivative derived from this jejunum, pre-arterial segment of this midgut, ileum, pre-arterial segment of this midgut lobe, small post-arterial segment of this midgut lobe, proximal to the sickle bud, cecum and appendix derived from this sickle bud of the post-arterial segment of this midgut lobe, ascending colon and proximal 2/3 of this transverse colon derived from this post-arterial segment of the midgut lobe behind the sickle bud. Now you see this primitive development of this foregut, midgut and hindgut. This one are this esophagus, stomach, duodenum, jejunum, ileum. Here there is a not development pre-arterial segment and post-arterial segment and hindgut. This part are the cloaca and allantois. This one are the vitellin duct. Here there is a joining with this yolk sac to form the umbilicus. So in front of this foregut, there is a development of this liver. This one are the development of this liver. Here there is a falciform ligament. This part are the diaphragm, bare area of the liver, lesser omentum, behind there is a greater omentum. This one are the dorsal mesogastrium. So foregut, it supply the ciliac artery, midgut supply the superior mesenteric artery, and hindgut supply the inferior mesenteric artery. So this one are the in general डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस जीआईटी ट्रैक. सो इसलिए फोरगट की जो डेरिवेटिव उसको सप्लाई करती है ब्रांचेस ऑफ दिस सिलिक आर्टरी. जो मिडगट है डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस मिडगट इट सप्लाई बाय दिस सुप्रीम मेसेंटरिक आर्टरी एंड डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस हाइंडगट इट सप्लाई बाय द इंफीरियर मेसेंटरिक आर्टरी. नाउ फर्स्ट यू सी दिस मिडगट कहाँ से डेवलप होता है. मिडगट फ्रॉम दिस सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस ड्यूओडेनम up to this half of this transverse colon. So in initial stage, first there is a pre-arterial segment and post-arterial segment. This one are the pre-arterial segment, this one are the post-arterial segment in compared in axis with this superior mesenteric artery. So here development of this midgut initial superior mesenteric artery ke sath jo hai यहाँ पे इनिशियली फिजियोलॉजिकल अम्बिलिकल हर्निया होता है. सो फिजियोलॉजिकल अम्बिलिकल हर्निया It is nothing but first stage of this midgut. There is a development outside the abdominal cavity. So this name is given this physiological hernia. Later it regress and goes inside the abdominal cavity. Regression of this or reduction of this hernia. So here there is a normal development of this midgut. So initial rotation is occur outside the abdominal cavity. Later two rotation occur within this abdominal cavity. So midgut it develop and it rotated three times 90 degrees. So 90, 90, and 90, total 270 degree rotation होता है with pre arterial and post arterial segment. So rotation of this midgut while it is in the umbilical cords, the midgut loops rotate 90 degree counter clockwise around the axis of the superior mesenteric artery. This bring cranial limb to the right and the caudal limb to the left. During rotation, the midgut elongate and form the intestinal lobe, jejunum and ileum. So this one are the rotation of this midgut occur 90 degree counterclockwise around the axis of this superior mesenteric artery. Now during the rotation, the midgut elongate and form the intestinal loop. Example, jejunum and ileum. So you can see this 90 degree rotation along the axis of the superior mesenteric artery outside the abdominal cavity. So initial rotation A wala jo diagram B hai, this one are the pre-arterial segment, post-arterial segment, and this one are the superior mesenteric artery. So initial 90 degree rotation outside the abdominal cavity. Here this outside abdominal cavity and rotation of this midgut name is given this physiological hernia. Later it reduce and regress within this abdominal cavity. So another 90 degree rotate within the abdominal cavity. Dusra 90 degree also rotate within this abdominal cavity. So first 90 degree rotation outside the abdominal cavity. Later 180 degree rotation within this abdominal cavity. So this one are this rotation of this midgut. Initial stage, this one are the pre-arterial segment, post-arterial segment. Here there is a bud or the sickle bud, development of the sickle, first 90 degree. So pre-arterial segment hai aur post-arterial segment rotate hota hai 90 degree. उसके बाद प्री आर्टेरियल सेगमेंट एंड पोस्ट आर्टेरियल सेगमेंट फर्दर रोटेट होता है 290 डिग्री, टोटल 180 डिग्री रोटेशन विद इन द एब्डोमिनल कैविटी. एंड हियर देयर इज अ सेकम इज हायर देन इट इज डिसेंड डाउनवर्ड टू बिकम ए नॉर्मल एडल्ट पोजीशन. सो हाउ इट इज रोटेट, यू सी द स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम टू शो द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द pre-arterial and post-arterial segment of this midgut loop during the different phase of its rotation. So this one are the pre-arterial segment, this one are the superior mesenteric artery, this one are the post-arterial segment. Initial rotation hoga to ye yahan pe aa gaya aur ye yahan pe aa gaya. To ye jo B diagram hai, pre-arterial segment left side hai, post-arterial segment right side. Then further 90 degree rotation, total 180 degree rotation. तो C में आएगा, यहाँ से rotate होके यहाँ पे आ जाएगा और A rotate होके यहाँ पे आ जाएगा. So this C is the diagram of the 90 degree rotation. First 90, second 90 and third 90 degree. So right and left side. So this one is the pre-arterial segment यहाँ पे आ गया, post-arterial segment यहाँ पे आ गया. Pre-arterial segment में से second part of this duodenum from the opening of this sphincter and up to this sickle bud. So these are derived from this jejunum and part of this duodenum derived from this pre-arterial segment. Then ileum and transverse colon, half of the transverse colon derived from this postaortic arterial segment. Also ascending colon and cecum and appendix is derived from this postarterial segment. Now at the 6th week, physiological umbilical hernia from 5th week to remain in this position up to 10 weeks. So this name is given this physiological umbilical hernia. So here you see this rotation occur outside the abdominal cavity, first 90 degree. So cranial limb and caudal limb. So this first rotation at the 6th weeks of the embryo, up to the 5th week there is a physiological umbilical hernia. 6th week mein wo rotation hota hai. It remains in this position up to the 10th week. Physiological hernia 10th week tak rahega. Then it later regress. 10th week reduction of this physiological midgut hernia, and here there is a another rotation occur within this abdominal cavity. So here you see this midgut loop, pre-arterial segment, post-arterial segment, this one are the supramesenteric artery, this one are the midgut loop. So 10th week reduction of this physiological midgut hernia. Now small bowel, jejunum and ileum. You see this arrow is indicated jejunum and ileum. It joined with this first stage anticlockwise rotation, right cranial and caudal on left side. So first stage anticlockwise rotation. So stages of this rotation of this gut divide into these three stages. First stage, when the U-shaped loop lows in this umbilical sac and spheric link of the mid gut is subjected to downward pressure by the caudal edge of this right lobe of this liver. Eventually, the cephalic limb rotate downward and to the right, and as a consequence, the cranial limb move upward and to the left. So during the first stage, the intestinal loop rotate through the angle of 90 around the axis of this supramesenteric artery. When viewed from this front, the rotation is anticlockwise. So this one are the first rotation anticlockwise, right cranial and left one are the caudal part. Now second stage, you see this third cranial part, lower part. So here this one are the cranial part, this one are the caudal part. So caudal part or the cecal swelling moves upward and cranial part moves downward. So this one are the first stage of this rotation. So cranial part left small intestine about the 11 weeks. So this one are this caudal part, this one are the cranial part. Here there is a cecum derived from this cecum diverticulum, and here there is a 90 degree rotation. Now at the 10th to 11th week of the embryo, cecum rotate to the its normal position. So here you see this cecum, it is descend down at the right iliac fossa, and here there is a diverticulum from the cecum and the appendix are developed. So this one are the 10th to 11th week of this embryo. At the second stage, during the 5 week of this embryo, in the physiological umbilical hernia. Hello. So in this physiological umbilical hernia, the right limb small gut segment of the midgut loop undergoes enormous elongation and is arranged in this series of this coil. So progressively decrease in this dimension of this liver and the mesonephric kidney, and a concomitant expansion of this abdominal part of this coelomic cavity. So it allow the herniated intestinal loop to re-enter the abdomen from this umbilical coelom. But the umbilical hernia cannot be reduced mass because of this intestinal loop become normal. So this one are this 10th week of this. Now return the midgut loop to abdomen. During the 10th week, the intestine return to the abdomen. What caused the return of this intestine is not known, but decrease in the size of the liver and kidney and enlargement of this abdominal cavity are important factors. This process is called the reduction of this physiological midgut hernia. Now, return of this midgut loops to abdomen, the small intestine form from cranial limb return first. It pass posterior to the superior mesenteric artery and occupy the central part of this abdomen. So this one are the large intestine return. It undergoes further 180 degree counterclockwise rotation. So this one are later it become the abdominal within this right side of this abdomen. Now cecum and appendix. Cecum, the primordium of this cecum and the appendix, the cecal diverticulum appear in 6 weeks as a swelling on the anti-mesenteric border of the caudal limb of the midgut. The apex of this cecal diverticulum does not grow as rapidly as the rest of it. The appendix is initially small diverticulum of the cecum. So this one are the occur development of this cecum. Now pre-arterial segment and post-arterial segment caudal part of this midgut loop, and here there is a cecum and terminal part of this ileum. So this one are the ileum, this one are the cecum, here there is a appendix is developed. Now which are the type of this cecum? First, fetal or the conical type, infantile type or the quadrate, this one are the type 2. Here there is a right cecal sacula and left cecal sacula. Normal type 3, these are the right cecal pouch and normally it open just below the opening of this ileum. So here there is a 2 orific within this cecum, ileocecal junction and the orific of this appendix. This exaggerated type, this one are the type 4, is given this exaggerated. Now you can see this development of this cecum. Normally these are the stages of this development of this cecum. Appendix is developed here, in this diverticulum there is formation of this cecum and appendix. Now here you can see this development of this midgut. What is the summary? Primitive gut start elongated first, intestinal loop form. This is the primary intestinal loop. That part of this primary intestinal loop that grows faster give rise to the jejunum and ileum. This is where the vitelline duct connect the yolk sac to the midgut. Primary intestinal loop herniate out into the umbilical cord. As it does this, it rotated 90 about the axis of the superior mesenteric artery. At 70 days, the loop is pulled back into the abdominal cavity. As this happened, the loop rotated 180 again around the superior mesenteric artery. So the primary intestinal rotated as total 270 around the superior mesenteric artery. This result in the cecum ending upright under the liver. The cecum now start to drop toward the right iliac fossa and the pulls the large intestine with it. The jejunum and the ileum both end up on the left side. Now applied anatomy. First, exophthalmos. You see this diagram. Here there is a Wharton jellies. It is part of this umbilical cord. Within there is a amnion and there is an intestinal loop. Name is given this exophthalmos or omphalos. So what is omphocele or the exophthalmos? When the primitive midgut loop failed to enter the abdominal cavity from the physiological umbilical hernia, a bulky mass is found in this umbilical cord at the birth. This condition is known as the exophthalmos, which is covered only by the amnion. So this diagram you can see there is a exophthalmos. The primitive gut loop failed to enter the abdominal cavity from physiological hernia and bulky mass is found in this umbilical cord at the birth. This clinical condition name is given this exomphalos. Now you see this abdominal viscera herniated into the base of this umbilical omphocele. This clinical condition is also name is given this omphocele or the exomphalos. Now second, congenital omphoceles. Here there is a abdominal contail come out through this umbilical region. Now you see this amnion covering omphoceles herniated sac is epithelium of this umbilical cord. Name is given the umbilical cord. So anterior abdomen wall and umbilical cord. Now umbilical hernia, when the intestine return back to the abdominal cavity during the 10th week and then herniate through the imperfectly closed umbilicals and umbilical hernia form. This is different form and omphoceles. In umbilical hernia, the protruding mass is covered by the subcutaneous tissue and the skin. Hernia reaches its maximum size and is reached its maximum size to umbilical hernia, the protruding mass is covered by subcutaneous tissue and the skin. Hernia reaches its maximum size at the end of this first month after the birth. So this one are the umbilical hernia. Here there is a herniation of this umbilical. Now umbilical hernia, it usually range from 1 to 5 cm. The defect through which the hernia occurs is the linea alba. Hernia protrude during this crying, staring or coughing. In case easily be reduced through the fibrous ring at the umbilicals. Surgery is not usually performed until it persists to the age of 3 to 5 years. So this one are the umbilicals hernia. Now gastroschisis or open stomach or the split. Anterior abdominal wall defect. So this one are the gastroschisis. Now abnormality of this midgut rotation. So here you can see this some non-rotation, if there is failed to rotation, this abnormality name is given this non-rotation, mixed rotation, reverse rotation, subhepatic cecum and internal hernia. So here there is a valvulus or the twisting of this physiological abdominal malrotation. Now what is the stenosis and atresia of the intestine? Parietal occlusion is stenosis or the narrowing of this lumen. Partial occlusion. Complete occlusion is atresia, no lumen of the intestinal lumen. So this one are the stenosis or the atresia. So in case of this atresia or stenosis, there is narrowing of this lumen. This clinical condition name is given this or no lumen, usko hum bolenge atresia. You see this diagram, here there is a lumen is narrow, so this name is given this stenosis. Here there is a no lumen, name is given this atresia. So Meckel's diverticulum, this outpouching is one of the most common anomalies of the digestive tract. This congenital ileal diverticulum occurs in 2 to 4% of these people. 3 to 5 times more prevalent in male than the female. It sometimes become inflamed and cause the symptom that mimic appendicitis. So this Meckel's diverticulum, it is the another clinical abnormality of this small intestine. So under the normal condition, the vitellointestinal duct disappear completely during the 6 weeks of this embryo. But in 2% of this human subject, its proximal part, 2 to 4% of these people, proximal part is persist. Usko hum bolenge Meckel's diverticulum, which is attached to the anti-mesenteric border of this ileum, about 2 to 3 feet proximal to the ileocecal junction. So usually the diverticulum is 2 inch long and possess the same caliber as that of the ileum. The tips of the diverticulum may be free or attached by the fibrous band to the umbilicals. So name is given this Meckel's diverticulum. So what is the complication of the Meckel's diverticulum? So you see this diagram, this one at the yolk sac, this one at the mesentery, midgut loop, and this one at the Meckel's diverticulum. Here there is a persistence of this part of this intestine, name is given the Meckel's diverticulum. So due to this Meckel's diverticulum, there is formation of this peptic ulcer followed by the perforation, then inflammation followed by the peritonitis, intestinal obstruction, loop of this small gut, may encircle the fibrous band of this diverticulum, and this produce the intestinal obstruction. So you can see when the appendix, and here there is a formation of this, you can see 2/5 away from its Meckel's diverticulum. Now Meckel's diverticulum, ileal diverticulum, so also name is given this ileal diverticulum because it appear at the ileum. Now here there is a ileal diverticulum, this one are the fibrous cord, here there is a umbilicoenteric fistula, vitelline cyst, umbilical sinus, and vitelline artery. These are the another abnormality or the congenital anomaly of this gut. In case of this fistula, here there is a sinus, cyst, or fistula. So if fistula hai, when the vitelointestinal duct remain completely patent, the contain of this small gut are discharged at the umbilical. This clinical symptom name is given this fistula. If there is a fibrous cord, this name is given this ileodiverticulum, and here there is a umbilicals of anterior abdominal wall, and there is formation of this fibrous cord. These all are the anomalies, the congenital anomalies of this midgut. Enterocystoma, sometimes the vitelline duct is closed at the both end but remain patent in middle. The cyst thus form lies beneath the umbilicals. So name is given this vitelointestinal cyst. Sometimes there is a tumor like appearance, name is given this raspberry tumors of the umbilicals. This one are the umbilical sinus, here there is a fistula, both hand is open, here there is a formation of this cyst, name is given the vitelline cyst, vitelline fistula, the umbilical fecal fistula, umbilical sinus. This part are the malrotation or the anomalies due to this error of this rotation of this gut. First, you see this cecum is midline, ileum and jejunum on the right side, on the left side there is ascending colon and transverse colon. So this one are the abnormal rotation. Here you can see this transverse colon goes down behind or posteriorly, and anteriorly there is a small intestine. So this also this error of this rotation of this midgut. If during this non-rotation of the midgut, some umbilical ring remain dilate and permit the reduction of this umbilical hernia. After initial 90 rotation, as a result a small gut occupy the right side of the abdomen and cecum with this associated colon is accommodated on the left side. If there is a reverse rotation, sometimes there is a reverse rotation hoga, to kya hoga? Of the midgut, in this anomalies, the cecum entered the abdomen first through the dilated umbilical ring and rotated the upward and to the right behind the origin of the superior mesenteric artery. So transverse colon extend behind the trunk of the superior mesenteric artery, and the third part of this duodenum lies in the front of this that of these vessels. So this one are the error of this rotation. Now I will take you the So have a nice day. Keep running and keep